Ny-Ålesund, Svalbard, is in fact the northernmost continuously inhabited place on Earth. We are at 79 degrees north, about 11 degrees east. Svalbard is an archipelago that's north of Norway, halfway between mainland Norway and the North Pole. And it's a great area for research because in a very small geographic area, you have a huge range of environmental conditions.
Before Ny-Ålesund was a research station, it was a coal mining village. And it started in early 1900s with the Kings Bay Coal Company.
It's a Norwegian settlement, but there was big accidents in the mines. And a lot of lives were lost, I believe, at that time. And they shut the mine down.
In 1962, that was the end of the mining period. But as Ny-Ålesund had a very good infrastructure, it was a good place to use it for research. The Norwegian Polar Institute has had a whole year presence here in Ny-Ålesund from 1968, and it's linked to environmental science, disciplines atmosphere, terrestrial ecosystems, marine science, and glaciology. The Norwegian Polar Institute hosts a lot of its own researchers, in addition to the other institutes in Ny-Ålesund, who also host their own.
There's AVIPEV, which is a combination of German and French efforts from two different institutions. There's Chinese, the English, there's all sorts of, like, the Italians have a station here. A lot of countries have research stations in Ny-Ålesund.
So it's 11 countries divided on 10 stations that has a permanent or semi-permanent presence in Ny-Ålesund. The capacity is around 200 researchers at the time, but it fluctuates with the seasons. During summer, it's the high season. There's atmospheric research that is going on throughout the whole year, but there is also activity during the winter time. And we see that more and more people are interested in polar night biology, for example.
Kings Bay is basically the facilitator for the station. We organize transportation, we provide logistics, solutions for all the institutions. And we also work as a coordinator between the projects, manage the projects as well, together with NPI, of course. And it takes a village, for sure, to make this scientific community work as well as it does. To keep it running, we have plumbers, we have receptionists, chefs, all of it. A lot of people with open minds and very easygoing and willing to get the job done.
So life here is not so different from the mainland, but in other ways it's very much different. You spend your life and your time in a very different way, where you live more or less together, you spend all meal times together, you do a lot of social activities together. It's a much more social life.
It's a lot of treats that we have up here, both like in terms of the rooms. Every room is very unique. Food wise it's amazing, and we have a lot of facilities that are helping you as a local to get out and do your hobbies. You can rent a boat, you can have a snowmobile, you can have dogs here if you are into that. There's a gym, there's a sauna, there's a jacuzzi. So it's very up-to-date living-wise. All the different labs are also really well prepared and well run.
Ny-Ålesund is a radio silent place, so people have to turn off Wi-Fi and Bluetooth on their personal devices, which includes your computer, your mobile phone, your headphones, your AirPods, and whatever other equipment you must have.
It's a lot of field safety. Field safety in regards of how to dress, how to read the terrain, what to expect when you're out here, temperatures. And then, of course, we do safety courses for polar bear safety with the new people who come here.
In Ny-Ålesund, polar bears very seldom go through the settlement because they're probably a little bit scared of the sounds here and the lights here. But to be safe, all doors are open, so if there is an encounter, people can go into the closest house. So whenever you're out in the field, you need to carry polar bear protection, which involves always carrying a rifle and some scaring device. So we use normally flare guns, and if we have an encounter, we always try to scare them the first. So the rifle is just to use in dramatic, extreme situations.
It's been a wild experience so far. We have the northernmost lying apartment, the northernmost post office. The community here is very comfortable and you have everything you need. So it's very easy to forget where you are. When I have visitors, sometimes they are just standing in awe because you can feel quite at home, I think. It's a cool place with both community and research.